Hey, brothers and sisters, it's Brother Patrick again, about the PayPal. For those of you who love Joshua's ministry, this is for you, those who love the ministry, not for those who run to and fro on the internet calculating rapture dates. But anyway, brothers and sisters, the PayPal, you know, I wanted to repeat what they said. You cannot put in the memo that it's for the Philippines or orphanages. It's against PayPal regulations. And I'll tell you what it is. You know, the owner of PayPal, the founder of PayPal, is an open flame and homosexual. And he was even at the Republican National Convention and he spoke, you know, and then Trump says he's not allowed, he don't want to have persecution of Christians, but he probably doesn't know about it. And if I knew I could get a message to Trump, I would, because he's supposed to be personal friends with the founder of PayPal. And but anyway, you know, it's a Christian persecution. It's against their policies and regulations to allow people to collect for charities through PayPal. But people can donate for my travels. So if you donate, you have to put in the memo for travels, or you can leave the memo blank. You know, and I've got the book that the Lord gave me to write. If you want to get, you know, purchase a book, you can donate for that, to purchase a book, you know, and give for that, or the prayer oil that I made. But I'm out of prayer oil right now and I'm getting ready to travel, so there's no more prayer oil right now. But anyway, brothers and sisters, Brother Terry, the people from PayPal are so God haters, they're even stalking on my YouTube channel too. They even got on there before they only had the joshuasministry.com website, and they told me to remove any reference to PayPal from there, which I did. Then the Facebook group, they asked me to remove any reference from PayPal from the Facebook group of Joshua's Ministry, which I did. And now they've even started stalking on my YouTube channel and saying that I need to remove any references to people giving, you know, they and other people could give for my travels or something. That's it. Can't put any references on there about the Philippines and orphanages and all that. So our other PayPal account, you know, has to be cleared. And the same thing like with mine, what they're saying is that you have to, you know, sign a online electronic affidavit that you won't, you know, solicit donations for the Philippines, because the Philippines is on the black list. And it's also, you know, Christian charities are also on there. Now, if you have like something like the Red Cross or something, yeah. But not a Christian organization or a church. But if you're a nonprofit, Red Cross or something like that, if you have some kind of registration with the government for that, or an NGO, a non-governmental organization through the UN or something, they can use PayPal, of course, because they're part of the New World Order. But churches and Christianity cannot. So here's the deal, brothers and sisters. PayPal is very, you know, is everybody wants to use PayPal. And I know that I remember Pastor Dave, as I mentioned before, he made a video about it when I had the first trouble back in April. And he tried some other kind of services, and he said that people don't like it, people don't want to use it, so PayPal is the only one other than check or money order. So, of course, I've got Bitcoin, but, you know, Bitcoin is real hard to deal with, more complicated to set up and deal with. And then, of course, Bitcoin can go way up or down, and it's very speculative, you know, it's a speculative kind of a thing. There's a group of investors who are trying to get people to start using Bitcoin, but it's not, you know, really, who knows if it'll turn out to be good, or it's just a trend. I don't know, you know, it's a speculative thing. But anyway, so check or money order, brothers and sisters, is about what we got to go with. I know everybody wants to use, you know, PayPal is very convenient, but we still got it. You can still use it, and I just don't know how long it'll last. The thing about it is, you know, I'm good to go for now, as long as no one else sends and puts on their orphans. Or if they do, and I don't know how often they might monitor me, if it's random, or, you know, Big Brother, or are they stalking, you know, they've got some kind of a filter system that picks up if someone puts those words, and boom. But the thing is that, you know, even if they do freeze my account and say you're not allowed to use PayPal anymore, within after 6 months, they release the funds. So if anybody gives, like I say, it's good to go now. Our other account with Brother Terry in Australia is temporarily frozen until we remove any reference to Joshua's ministry from the YouTube, like this video. I have to remove it when I'm posting it here in the last few videos. He said all the videos. I can't go back and do all 1,000 videos, but I'm not going to do that. But anyhow, you know, it's just, you know, continue to use PayPal if you can, and then when it's over, when they're finally going to, you know, clamp it down more, than that's it. So what are you going to do? I mean, check or money order is the only way to go. The only problem is, of course, having the Philippines to get the funds over there. That's a whole other thing. So, you know, maybe I can just, if I fly to the U.S. once a year, which I'm planning on doing anyway. And then if I collect the funds and then wire it over there, like now, people that sent me checks and money, those people sent me checks and money order, and then I saved it. And then I just today, as a matter of fact, I wired it to myself in the Philippines. And then last in June, I wired some to the house mom of orphanage number one. She oversees it for me because our amount coming through Brother Terry had been down. But because of the PayPal situation we had in April, we can't really advertise the PayPal address. And so I guess I could say it in the video. I don't know if they're watching the videos or what. But it's just, can you imagine that PayPal is a corporation and there's someone there, they're actually stalking each person. You know, it's supposed to be like if someone is a drug dealer laundering money, international mafia or whatever, and they're, you know, sending money through PayPal to, you know, that's the law about money laundering or something like that. That's who it's for, you know, some kind of criminal activity when they have some kind of laws. But they're using that, and then PayPal is interpreting it to mean that, you know, even Christian organizations, churches, and everything else. So it's just an outright persecution of Christians. You know, could you imagine? It's just, so the only thing we can do is checks or money order, and then I've just got to have, you know, somebody to wire it over there to me. I actually have one relative who's a Christian, but he's only 19. But I can get him, you know, just to do the wire transfer, I guess. You know, let it build up, and then maybe we can do it, you know, just once I get it set up. I guess I need to take him to the bank and set it up. You know, and then like when I did it today, I mean, once you set it up, then you just go in there and they already got you in the system. So I guess I need to take him to the bank and get him set up and just do it that way. You know, the only thing about that is I have to, you know, deal with IRS. I mean, I have to claim, the bad part is, of course, when people donate, I have to put it as income, and then I have to submit an itemized report of when I sent it to the Philippines and all that. It's more paperwork, but, you know, as opposed to the other way, I'm not dealing with that. Because when you're an international country, like if you're an American, you live in an international country, you know, you can have $100,000, up to $100,000 worth of income, and it's, you don't have to pay taxes or claim it. You don't have to pay any kind of tax. Whereas in the States, I have to, you know, it's possible that I'd have to pay tax on people's donations, and I have to do itemized whole thing on it, which I didn't have to since I've been doing it, but, you know, the government. So anyway, brothers and sisters, it's a big hassle, and I ask you guys to pray about it. And I mean, they're going to unlock it. It's just that, you know, how often are they going to keep stalking on the videos and looking, you know, how can people donate if they don't know what the address is? So, you know, a lot of times people give, some people who give, you know, people always try to put a button on there. Just put a button on there, put a button on there. The thing is, you put a button, that triggers it. I tried to do the button the first time. That's how the first account got locked up 3 years ago, because I put in a donate button, and then somebody clicked it, and then this likes automatic. Flag to them, and they're like, oh, are you the Red Cross, or who are you, know, how are you having people donate? So like they are like the, you know, trying to put themselves, well, it's just persecution of Christianity. It's a persecution of Christianity, brothers and sisters. I know people who have donate buttons on their channels. As a matter of fact, I think on YouTube, all the people that are not doing a ministry have donate buttons on their channel, and then they're self-appointed pastors, and they don't have, they're not doing orphanages and stuff. You know, they're not doing anything like that, but they have donate buttons. I think almost all these people that are making videos have donate buttons. And, you know, their PayPal's working out. You know, I don't know the deal. Maybe because somehow where we've done the international wire transfers, there's some kind of a, you know, connection where it goes through Big Brother, and it's like comes some kind of a deal. You know, that's what Brother Peter in Canada was saying. Maybe it's something to do with, like, the Homeland Security thing or something, whatever, part of the Patriot Act and all this. Supposed to be for terrorists and criminals, but it's used against Christians. That's probably what it is, how we get flagged when we do these international wire transfers. You know, this is what, you know, I'm doing the same thing that a denomination does, you know, a missions organization does, but I'm doing it myself instead of all that overhead with a missions board and all that. And so then they have some kind of a, you know, they've got themselves hooked up, you know, like the Southern Baptist or whomever you want to talk about. So that's the difference. And then they spend a lot of the money goes to all their, you know, administrative stuff or whatever. But we don't have that. But anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, as long as we have funds, I'm going to maintain the orphanages. As long as we have funds and God makes a way, I'll do it. But if we don't have funds, we can't do the orphanages. So, you know, I'll keep you posted. If you know, like I said, I think if people send checks and money order, you know, like I said, I've got a relative. I guess he can always send it to me. But I'm planning on coming back to the States every year, I guess, and visit people and do, you know, here in the States with the Joshua's ministry and the YouTube here. So you know, at that time I could probably, you know, if I can, you know, get like a whole year's worth over there, it'd be awesome. And just try it, wire it to myself and to the house parents maybe, you know, so, you know, because probably have a limit on how much you can have your account in the Philippines. I think they do. But anyway, brothers and sisters, praise God. Praise God. You know, I know God will make a way. I ask you guys to pray about it. I got some great messages from the Lord, but, you know, the enemy just keeps trying to attack. But like I say, it's up to the Lord. It's the Lord's ministry, the Lord's orphanages. He wants to keep going. He's going to have to make a way. And so I ask you guys to pray about it. I know God will make a way.